What's up guys, GoldEvil91 here. I'm voice narrating the first part of this video because the audio is messed up. So basically this video is going to show you guys how to mic spam in all Valve Source games that have voice chat and the ability to use console and binds. In a video that I have uploaded a while back, did you want to mic spam in Ventrilo? I'm not sure if it works for TeamSpeak, but it works for Ventrilo. So, it's going to be on the screen somewhere, and I'll put it in the description too, if you don't know how to click on things like annotations. But anyway, out of the assumption that you know how to use these programs, I'll still tell you what is necessary. You'll need a virtual audio cable, and you need to configure it correctly, and you'll need Winamp. Preferably the latest version, because of major bug fixes, etc. So this is what you're going to need to do first. You're going to open Winamp. It's on my other screen, but I'm going to drag it here because I can't record both. I can only drag it. Alright, here's Winamp. Next, you'll need to enable the line 1 on both recording and playback. That is there after you install it. And make sure that Show Disabled and Disconnected Devices is checkmarked, so they'll appear. Once you enable both of them, you'll still be able to talk in programs like Ventrilo if you have set your microphone to be the default device. So don't worry about line 1 being the default communication device when you're recording. You'll still be able to talk in programs like Ventrilo, but in-game and other kind of chats like Steam or Skype will not work. So when you're mic spamming, you basically can't talk anywhere else besides programs where you can set the default microphone device. This is what you need to do next. This is just going to be a review. You press this part of Winamp. You go to Options, Preferences. You configure whichever one works best with yours. Wave Output version 2.13 works best for me. Press Configure and click on Line 1 Virtual Audio Cable. You won't need to tweak any of these unless you know how to do them. If you don't, the default should be okay. Click on OK and close. Now, Winamp will stream music on your recording device, line 1, depending on which music you play. Before I continue on with this video, I'm going to go offline and Steam just to make sure I'm not bothered. Okay. Now, what you'll need to do, after you have Winamp opened and both line 1 set to default communication device, if I didn't mention already, you'll need to set both of them to the default communication device. After you do that, and you still want to talk with friends, like when you're trolling in game, I recommend you go on a Ventrilo server and just go in channel with them. But this is how you mic spam in game. You get all your music you want, import it from iTunes or import it from your music folder or wherever you keep your music. This is all my music. After you do all that, you need to also have HLDJ. I'm pretty sure I linked this, or I did not use HLDJ for mic spamming in Ventrilo, so I'll tell you how to use it. To add a game, either on Source or, forgot the other engine. It was Source and Gold Source, I guess. But Source are the games you're going to want to be spamming with. The play audio key is default on F1, but I use for P because basically every game I mic spam on, the P key is not in use, so that's convenient enough. You add a game by searching for the game directory. The full game directories made by Valve should look like this. You go to steamapps, your username, and the game you want to use. And it's kind of stupid to use a single player game like HL2 or any of the other ones in Portal, because you can't voice chat on there. But Garry's Mod would be a good example. You open the Garry's Mod folder, and you're probably going to be confused because you think this is the directory. Sorry for that brief cut off guys if you noticed that, but as I was saying, the directory for your Valve Source game should be an abbreviation or the exact same thing as your title, as your game title. For example, Garry's Mod. The directory folder is Garry's Mod because it's the folder within Garry's Mod. Well, I'm going to show you a different one, like TF2 for example. The directory for TF2 is just TF, which is basically just an abbreviation of TF2. So you get my point, you click on directory, you hit OK, you give it a name, you the audio directory. The only reason that we're using HLDJ for this is because it's much more convenient, because you don't have to hold down your stream key, talk key. There's a play audio key where you just press it once, it's toggle, so we're not going to save any audio crap, because this is worthless for audio streaming. We're only using this to toggle our stream. That's where Virtual Audio Cable and Winamp come in. So after you add your game, you highlight the game you want to use. I'm using GMod, and you click the start button. I'm glad to have to end this because Camtasia can't record games, and I'm going to record for apps. Actually, before I end it, this is how it's going to work. If you have a second display or monitor, I recommend you drag Winamp over and you put your game in window mode. So whenever you want to change a song to annoy more people, you can easily just move your arrow out of the thing without minimizing the entire game because it's in window mode. And on your second display, which you can't see, you can select a song you want to do again. I'm going to drag Winamp back over. The recommended volumes I use, if you're going to use the default Winamp, I recommend you put the volume to around 10 to 15 max, because then it gets too loud. I've tested it and had people themselves give me advice on the quality and the sound. And 14 is about my average best. So yeah, don't put your volume over 15 unless you want people to become really annoyed if you're really trying to play just music for them in a game. So yeah, now you click start. And then I'll show you in-game what to do. Alright guys, I'll see you in-game. Alright, what's up guys? It's me, IngariusMod. You probably can't tell because I'm recording with Fraps, but I've already set my settings for run in a window and 1280x720 because my native resolution is 1360x768. And if you're going to be running in windowed mode, what's the point of running in windowed mode if it's just taking up the entire screen? So make your resolution the one smaller than your native so you have some space on your desktop. Now what you need to do is, if you really want to test it, you can test it while playing a Winamp song. I'll do it right now to prove that this method does in fact work. If you have any questions or if I went by too quickly, please just tell me. This is a random gay Green Day song I'm playing. Here it is. Doesn't sound like the best quality when you record it, but trust me, it is decent quality to other players. I've heard it. I've heard other people use this method. And yeah, you hear the music work. It's by Green Day. Alright. So this method does in fact work. If you put your voice receive on the max, chances are it's going to sound too loud, so you shouldn't mess with your voice receive, and probably put it halfway or less. Your transmit should be whatever you want, because it's just going to sound the same to everyone with line 1. Now in console, this is what you need to type. Voice_loopback1. Voice_loopback1 basically means every time you talk, or as we're doing right now, transmit music, it will be heard back. It's like when you talk, you can hear yourself talk. That's how some people record commentaries, live commentaries in-game, where they talk, because it's just looping back your voice, basically. This works for every single Source Valve game that's multiplayer, so this method will basically work on everything else that you want it to work on. And the P key, as I set, will transmit my music. Now all you need to do is find a multiplayer game, but I don't feel like any band right now, so I'm just going to start my own game. Just to put on two-player and start it. Okay, as my world loads, I'm going to pray that you could actually use voice chat even if you're by yourself and start at a random server. Okay, when this world loads, I'll show you that it does in fact work. And I'll also link HLDJ in the description below. And yeah. Gotta wait for the game data to initialize. Any second now. And here we are. Voice chat does work. Alright, so I'm gonna press my P key, which transmits. As you see, after I press my HLDJ stream key, I'm not holding it down and it's still playing, so that's why we're using HLDJ for this. And every time you launch a game, you have to always use the HLDJ to launch it, so the bind still works. And you have to have line 1 enabled and 1 amp open beforehand, or it won't work, because it needs to be set up beforehand for some reason. So now I'm just gonna play a song to show you that voice loops it back, and the quality should sound okay if your voice receive isn't too loud. Other people should hear it better, because Valve manages to make voice chat better even though it sounds horrible on testing. So here's Gary Jules' Mad World. Might sound a little weird, but yeah. As you can see, it works. I don't know why it's making this, but usually when I do it, it sounds okay. And voice loopback is just to hear that it actually works. I'm gonna mute in game volume. As you can see, this method does in fact work. And the HLDJ method is patched for most Counter-Strike Source servers, a lot of Gary's Mod servers, and basically every TF2 servers. So HLDJ spamming does not work anymore. That's why you need to use line 1 and Winamp. This method also works for Ventrilo, which will be linked below the description. And yeah, you can just watch that video to see how to set up Winamp and set up virtual audio cable. See you guys later, and this works.